Welcome back to Overserved. Real quick before we start, if you like the direction this project is going, you can find last week's episode by clicking right here. Also, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel as it will do numbers for super producer Westoff's health. For obvious reasons, this week we're going to be a little bit less result-oriented, but there was still plenty of unintentional comedy from the tennis world, and in fact, a big piece of non-coronavirus-related news, although I suppose everything's related to the coronavirus at this point, but Roland Garros, they announced they're going to move this year's event to September 20th to October 4th now. For those of you who don't know, that means the event would be starting 6 days after this year's U.S. Open. It would also displace about 12 ATP and WTA events. So our friend Jonathan Newman came up with a GIF that I think perfectly describes everyone's reaction to this move. I came in like a wrecking ball.
I never hit so hard in love. God, I love that song. Woo!
Anyways, we weren't the only one feeling the spice after that move, as the U.S. Open, in an unprecedented incident, took to Twitter to respond to the French Open. Here was their statement. At a time when the world is coming together, we recognize that such a decision should not be made unilaterally. Oh! And therefore, the USTA would only do so in full consultation with the other Grand Slam tournaments, the WTA and ATP, the ITF, and our partners, including the Laver Cup. Westoff, I know you did this last time, so this is a translation of that USTA statement. You, French Open. But it gets even better, folks. The USTA mentioned the Laver Cup, and they came out with their own statement. And the reason this is important, that French Open date, September 20th to the October 4th, that middle weekend for the French would happen to overlap directly with the Laver Cup. And let's just say a few people over in Laver World weren't exactly happy. This announcement came as a surprise to us and our partners, Tennis Australia, the USTA, and the ATP. In other words, French Open, what the f*** were you doing? That's my translation, loosely. It raises many questions when we are assessing the situation. At this time, we want our fans, sponsors, broadcasters, staff, volunteers, players, and the great city of Boston, all right, easy, Laver Cup, to know that we intend to hold Laver Cup 2020 as currently scheduled. At Dry Volley nailed the sort of standoff we are in right now with this Twitter video.
Really?
It wasn't me. I'm not going down for this!
I want you to know that's what an editing session between me and Westoff also looks like. Now, I'm sure you must be wondering, since there's not much tennis going around, what are these professional players doing to pass the time? Well, that's why this Overserved segment is great. We get the chance to explore some of their funniest content that they've been putting out on tennis Twitter. Here, we have Alex Dimenauer playing with yet another doll. Let's watch.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
How are you doing?
I'm doing good, thanks.
I'm doing good, thanks.
Good.
This is entertaining.
Are you enjoying this lockdown? Yes, I am. Thank you very much.
Clearly, these players are struggling to pass the time, and as you know, if you played any tennis, we're all competitive, so they're all trying to find different ways to compete. Our friends at Tennis Channel putting on a toilet paper challenge that involves players bouncing toilet papers off the side of their racket as if it's a tennis ball. We've gotten some really good results thus far. Look at that focus. Typical Andrei Rublev. Pavlyuchenkova. Swing and a miss. Oh, Schwartzman going with his feet. Love to see that. What would Diego Schwartzman be better with? His racket or his feet? That was pretty impressive. Ons Jabeur good at anything she does right now. Oh, a little dance as well. Oh! One of the big questions facing all of us, particularly those of us that have to go on camera, is how am I going to stay in shape if I have to self-quarantine? Now, thankfully, Christian's come up with an in-home regimen that I think we all can follow along with, and we're going to try and do just that as she shows us what's what in this Instagram video.
All right, first things first, you want to get some water, throw in a splash of vinegar, find an old rag lying around the house, you want to get it wet, dab dab, and toss it on the floor. Now let's do this. First exercise up, we have the side lunge. According to Google, it works your glutes, quads, and hamstrings. If you want to make it more productive, you can spin around in a circle, thereby covering more surface area. Next up, we got mountain climbers. Get a little cardio in, heart rate up. You can make it more difficult by actually moving your hands as though you were going down a ladder. Lastly, we have the reverse lunge series. You could do single leg, alternating legs. If you want to be more productive, you can turn it into a reverse walking lunge. That way you cover more surface area. If you're feeling super ambitious, you can add some weight and burn them quads. According to my mother, Korean women have been using this technique since the beginning of time. That's how they stay so skinny.
It's not just the fitness side that's forcing players to get creative. Some of these players exploring their more artistic characteristics. Christian Lindell doing his best here to impersonate Skrillex. Courtney Mute says, hey, Christian, I see you're DJing. I'm going to raise you my first single. Moi, je veux leur dire à ces mecs-là, croyez en vous, ce n'est pas fini, croyez en vous, ce n'est pas fini. C'est vrai que c'est facile à dire, je suis un enfant, né à Neuilly, bien sûr que la vie est plus facile. Not too bad, Courtney, not too bad, but I see your first single. I'm going to raise you my own. Oh, man. I'm like cringing already. Yes, you're watching Overserved. You get the content you deserve on top of the game, and we won't fall. We like the Clay Rafa Nadal. I can rap fast, I can rap slow, just like Dennis with more flow. I'm grinding lyrics like Ferrer. Haters come at me if you dare. This is a low point for me. I just want you to know. We've got a DJ, we've got a rapper. Do we have any dancing? Oh. We've got dancing, and in fact, that might be the highlight of this downtime. So many pro athletes showing off their moves. None better than Heather Watson recreating this TikTok. So we tried the workouts. We tried the rapping. We're definitely going to try the dancing as well. Westoff, let's take this to the garage. We have a lot of fun on these overserves, but these are serious times, and we know you all are looking for advice to turn to now. And no one keeps serious entertaining quite like Ohio State men's tennis coach Ty Tucker, seen here in the same outfit he wore in his last match.
Hello, this is Ty Tucker, director of tennis at Ohio State. I want to encourage everybody to help as much as possible, especially with the elderly. We are going to get through this together, but we need all of the Buckeyes in Ohio to keep persevering and helping out as much as possible. Go Bucks.
So that's this week's Overserved. If you like what you're seeing, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking this button right here. Please, 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 Super Producer Daniel Westoff, promise me if we get to 1,000 that he'll let me wear a different shirt in our next video. So please hit the subscribe and thanks for watching. This is Overserved. He's done too. Oh, no, I was kidding. What up, buddy? Don't nip me.